This program is brought to you by thepodcastfactory.com.
Canine crew, it's time to just sell the damn thing. Doberman Dan is revealing his contrarian formula for getting a rush of new customers, building your business faster, and making the highest possible profits. Go to justselltheDamnThing.com to get your copy today.
Prepare yourself for the uncensored, nothing held back, no BS reality of how business and life really work. Doberman Dan is off the chain.
Jonathan got some feedback on our I Found the Cure for Cancer podcast.
Oh, yeah? What kind of feedback? You get a government grant or something?
Well, you know, for my ball peen hammer therapy? Yeah. No, I did not. but I found this interesting. Normally, I just ignore stupidity like this, but I just can't help but comment on it. Here's what the person said. Good old Calberto 869 said, didn't have the balls to use his or her name. It's got to be a guy. Women just don't do stupid things like this. So didn't have the balls to put his name on the email. He says, how dare you make a tasteless and insensitive joke about cancer? You're a very poor excuse for a human. I wish you and or your family members would never have to suffer the same fate as cancer victims and their families do. However, fate itself could play its own cruel jokes on you. So I'm a poor excuse for a human, and then he wishes cancer on me.
That's sick.
Is that hypocritical or what?
What a douche nozzle.
Well, first of all, so Calberto 869 is a little late to the party because I've already had cancer. And one of the biggest reasons I survived it is because I didn't submit to the ball peen hammer cancer therapy. I have also had two close family members, one being my own mother, die of cancer. Actually, I correct that. My mother opted for the ball peen hammer cancer therapy, and that killed her, not the cancer. So he's late to the party on both, talking about me getting cancer, having family members die. I have another close family member right now with stage 4 cancer. So he wants to wish that on me. He's late. But here's the deal. Is it possible for somebody to be so stupid that they just didn't get that? Is that possible, Jonathan?
You would be surprised how stupidity runs rampant in the U.S.
Well, I don't. This was well written, so he's literate. That's why I'm flabbergasted that somebody would be so stupid that they didn't get that episode. And I almost don't want to explain it because it's like explaining the punchline of
right.
a joke.
It doesn't even make any sense. That's the whole point. It's satire. Like, if you don't get that, then there's something clearly wrong with you.
Right. Yes, I was making a statement about the absurdity of cancer treatments. You know, the LA Times and the McGill Cancer Center in Montreal, Canada, they did surveys of oncologists, and 75% of the oncologists said if they or a family member had cancer, they would never use chemotherapy because they know it's highly ineffective and extremely toxic. So there's that. Yes, I was making a comment on that, but the deeper implication I was trying to make was how easy it is to manipulate allegedly intelligent people into buying into the most idiotic bullshit. Like, even the doctors, these are highly educated and really highly intelligent people that they just buy into this hook, line, and sinker. It is so easy to manipulate people into believing complete bullshit and buying into it to the point that, you know, they'll submit to something that will kill them, or they'll implement something that
assisted suicide.
Yeah. Exactly.
Gaborkian was a criminal for this, and then the drug companies are praised for it. What's wrong with this world?
That's why I was just completely blown away. Like, somebody didn't get it. And it's you know, now that I think about it, it's probably not stupidity. It's just this guy is a brainwashed robot sheeple drone. And he simply cannot think for himself, you know, attended government-funded youth indoctrination camp for 12 years, probably has continuing education after that. And he just, he can't get it. He literally can't see that the emperor has no clothes.
He's a total human resource. They're using his ass up.
Speaking of stupidity, I want to talk about some new ninja, doing finger quotes on ninja, internet marketing strategies. I love these online guys that talk about this ninja, super secret ninja strategy. You know, learn it this week and you'll be a millionaire by next week. So I want to talk about that.
There's some irony in that, though, because I'm pretty sure that you've done the research. I know I have, but in Japan, in feudal Japan, ninjas were actually disgusting, low-life killers who snuck around in the dark. So I don't understand how come they're being praised nowadays.
how that gets related to making money online, I have no idea. But it does. We hear that all the time. And I love it when rookies want to talk about internet marketing strategies with me.
Exactly.
I let them rattle on about all the things they want to rattle on about, all the things that they think are new, as I call them, BBSOs, stands for bullshit, bright, shiny objects. I mean, if I were to start making a list of them, since I started my first online business in 1996, so I've seen all this stuff
come and go. There was no internet back then.
Oh, yeah. Back when we had to walk to school uphill. 7 miles both ways and snow up to our neck.
With no shoes.
And saber-toothed tigers chomping at our butts. I've seen this. I've seen it all, man. I've seen SEO strategy secrets and tricks. Chatbots, that's a fairly recent one. Push notifications, that's a fairly recent one. Social media, when that was like the new thing and going to be the thing. Some people still think it is the thing. Pay-per-click, man. I was using Overture pay-per-click back before it was even Yahoo. Wow. CPA networks, all these. For a while, we went through all this glut of free traffic methods. I heard ninja a bunch of times associated with those. People talking about how to get these crazy low-cost clicks, all these secret tricks for that. Affiliate marketing, when that was the big BBSO. Banner advertising, when that was the BBSO. Actually, that's been a BBSO a couple for different a times.
Yeah, media buys.
Yep. Product launch formula.
Ooh. I forgot about that one.
Webinars, when that was the new thing. Ad nauseum, man. I've heard it all. I find it amusing because if any of these guys and gals had read the marketing classics, which is essential reading, in my opinion, they'd understand that none of that stuff is new. In fact, there is nothing new. If you're looking for new, you're going to be looking for a long time. Of course. You know, there are a lot of people who will try to sell you new. And there's a plethora of people selling, quote unquote, new. And it's usually pitched as a magic bullet. And it's always priced, you know, really high. But there's really nothing new. A lot of the stuff that was sold in the IM world, the internet marketing world, is new, was just like old direct response stuff repackaged and made to seem sexy and new. Yeah, there has been new media over the years, like radio, then TV, then the internet. But how to market and build a business, nothing new there. In fact, the principles of successful marketing are pretty simple. The problem is most rookies, and actually just based on my experience, even a few experienced marketers, allow themselves to get sucked into this BBSO syndrome. And then what that does, that distracts them from doing the tried and true marketing strategies that give the highest ROI.
I think that's the objective right there, actually, because I don't know, I was either thinking about this or writing about it somewhere, but that is the objective, to keep people distracted so they think they need another new answer, so they keep buying shit, never making money, and keep them in an endless cycle.
That's a good observation, JR. And I also think I'm working on an episode about the difference in the brains of action takers and doers versus procrastinators. I still don't have that one finished yet, but it'll be pretty interesting based on some new psychological research and brain scans and stuff. But in addition to what you just mentioned, I think that the chasing of the BBSOs by both wannapreneurs and people with a real business is just a method of procrastination. It's a way to keep the curtain from going up on their show, which is all based, it's all based on fear is what that's about. Like, well, I just need one more thing before I can really do this. Bullshit. You don't.
Ouch. I'm getting that right now too, bro. We all get it.
Oh, you will. You and me both. As the pastor of this church I used to attend back, before I was such a heathen as I am now, used to say, pay really close attention to what the pastor's preaching because that's what he's struggling with.
So, damn right.
You ain't alone. All that stuff that, we talked about, that list of all those BBSOs that have gone through phases of the new and sexy thing, those are all fairly easily learned skills. You can pay somebody surprisingly little to do all that stuff for you if you've mastered the most important skills that produce the highest ROIs in your business. And what, pray tell?
Yes.
Are those high ROI skills so sorely lacking in most internet marketers today, you ask, JR?
I do.
Understanding human nature and market behavior. And when you got that nailed down, you are the guy or gal who makes the world go round. And you don't have to immerse yourself in grunt work in chasing BBSOs. You can pay somebody else a pittance to do grunt work for you. All that stuff we talked, SEO, pay-per-click ads, social media, you can pay somebody else to do that for you. If you do choose to immerse yourself in the grunt work, you're severely limiting your income and your business growth and your time. Worst of all, your time freedom. That's the one resource you can never get back.
Just in case you're wondering.
What you should be immersing yourself in is the basic marketing and persuasion principles and the study of markets. And as a brief aside to that, really, if all you do is just master the first three chapters of Breakthrough Advertising by Gene Schwartz, you'll probably find yourself so far ahead of other marketers, it'll be downright scary. So leave the grunt work to lesser mortals, as Gary Halbert used to say. I don't try to tell these poor, clueless rookies they're on the wrong path. And to get back onto the right path, they need to stop reading internet marketing stuff and go back and study the old masters. I've tried that in the past. It doesn't work. It's just one ear and out the other.
Why not? Why doesn't it work? Are you not convincing enough or what?
I don't know. I think they want the magic money button and they think it's going to be, there is a magic money button. There is no magic money button. It's just, it's basic marketing principles. I mean, I've given up. I now just smile and pat them on their confused little heads because I know constantly looking for the new is going to result in two possible outcomes. The first, they'll be continually confused, frustrated, unproductive, and broke. Or the second, after this constant search for the new leaves them continually confused, frustrated, unproductive, and broke, they'll finally pull their head out of their ass and seek out the tried and true principles of marketing and persuasion that can be applied to any media.
How do they find that though, Dan? Because like these new guys, and this is something that I see all the time, and I'm going to take you off topic, but these new guys, they don't know any of the old time marketers, any of the old time direct response people. And so they're just looking further into the IM space or the biz ops space. But how would they then find these people? If they're not listening to this show, they might not be getting this opportunity to learn the good stuff.
Well, most won't because they just aren't committed enough and serious enough to go back and research where all this stuff came from. Shocking revelation. If you're an online marketer, you are a direct response marketer. I love it.
Ta-da!
When these online people say, yeah, I'd like to try some direct marketing. I just don't know anything about direct mail. I'm like, you dumbass. If you're selling online, you are a direct response marketer. But, you know, it's like somebody deciding they're going to be in the car business and they don't even know who Henry Ford is.
Who?
Well, yeah, that guy. You know, I just don't understand it. In this business, like most people will go back a few years. They'll think.
They think Frank Kern's the guy.
Yeah, they think. Well,
or Dan Kennedy.
He started this stuff. Well, you know, Frank Kern just took what the old direct response guy, the mail order guys. I mean, that goes back 100 years or more. He just took that and applied it to a different media, which was online. So, you know, how will they find it? Most won't. They just don't have the commitment to go through that, or they think it's irrelevant. It couldn't be more relevant. And most of the stuff they're studying couldn't be more irrelevant because it's based on fads. You know, when Facebook goes bye-bye or the ad costs go so high, it's no longer even usable. We're almost to that point, by the way.
Yeah.
Or, you know, they do like they've done with several high-profile people recently, and you build up this huge Facebook group, and then Facebook shuts down your account because whatever, they don't like what you stand for, or now you're not allowed to send messages to your group. Well, you know, so when you're focusing on that stuff that's a fad, you're screwed. When you focus on the timeless principles of direct response marketing, well, apply that to any media. So whatever the next fad is, just apply that to that while that fad lasts, you know, and then just ride that horse until it dies. But unfortunately, 3 decades plus experience as an entrepreneur has shown me like only 5% or less will allow themselves to get on to number two that I mentioned. Like after that constant search for new leaves them frustrated and broke, you know, they'll finally seek out the tried and true principles. The rest of the people, the 95%, are going to spend their entire career spinning their wheels. Or quit. And then we end up spinning their wheels after a while. Most people don't have the persistence to do that very long. So they'll quit. I mean, that's
quit
the,
and
the
die
ultimate
and
end
be
of
broke.
Let's, and
let's
die
paint
broke.
Some pictures, right? Let's paint some pictures of the reality of it.
Yeah, exactly. My point is searching for the new is a formula for frustration and failure. Let those poor suckers, those poor deluded rookies wallow in that misery. The truth is, there's nothing new for the true master of marketing. And a true master understands this and invests his life studying, rereading, and mastering the basics. And in spite of what the sellers of the BBSOs tell you, there are definitely no new, in spite of what I entitled this podcast, there are definitely no new internet marketing strategies, and there certainly are no new ninja internet marketing strategies. Let all these delusional saps chase fantasies, magic bullets, BBSOs, ninja tricks, and new internet marketing strategies. You be smarter than that. Invest your time and money in becoming a master of the timeless marketing principles, and therefore enjoy a lifetime of prosperity.
God, I'm feeling sad right now. You know, I had two conversations this week where people told me their new idea, and their new idea was, I'm going to give it all away for free. Then reciprocity will bring people back to me.
Oh my gosh.
I don't want to get you started on a tangent, but give us a teaser of what's coming up next time, Dan.
Oh, so next time, now you correct me if I'm wrong, but aren't we going to be... Oh, no. I got my episodes out of order.
Yeah.
Please forgive me. So next week, we're going to be talking about how to double your lifetime customer value.
Ooh, but you got to have customers, right?
Well, true. To do that,
one caveat.
You definitely have to have customers.
Can't wait. Cannot wait. All right. Another Off the Chain show is in the can. Thank you, Canine Crew, for tuning in. We'll be back all up in your ear holes next time. Canine Crew, before you run off, I want to remind you, Doberman Dan has set up an off-the-chain hotline. Call in, tell us you love us. It's even better if you tell us you hate us. It doesn't matter what you say. All you have to do is call in, leave a message. The number is 321-424-6043. Again, off-the-chain hotline, 321-424-6043. 888-346-6043.
This is the podcastfactory.com.